Okay, you've just described the Sofia platform a very grim situation with the media environment in the Western Balkans, Albania in particular. But the European Commission is starting to realize this is a problem and is starting to monitor and includes these observations in the progress reports it makes for the countries in the region. How would you comment on this change of approach maybe?
I think the situation is complex. We don't have to make dramas, but on the other hand, we don't have to ignore problems that we have in the Western Balkans and in the Balkans in general. All the Balkan countries are in the partly free zone of the Freedom House, for example. I think it's good that the European Commission is taking seriously media development and media freedom in the Balkans, because I think this is a lesson learned from what happened to the countries who already joined the European Union: Bulgaria, Romania, Slovenia, Hungary. What we see now actually is that the situation of freedom of expression in Sofia is not better than in Tirana, in Bucharest is not better than in Belgrade, in Budapest actually it's worse than, I can say, in Tirana or in Belgrade or in Podgorica. So, and so on. So, when it comes to media freedom, European integration did not work much. This is why I think Commission is taking seriously the Western Balkans, because we are still in the process of accession. Some countries are candidates, some are potential candidates, in different stages of European integration, but the problems are the same. And since the problems are the same, I think it's time to tackle, to touch the problems and to find some solutions, because the situation, let's say, with public broadcasting services is very problematic. Mm-hmm. The reform has failed in most of the countries. The situation of journalists in all our countries, it's a kind of situation of a media proletariat, as I described here. And
do you think the situation could change if the European Commission points to these specific problems?
If they use the better conditionality and leverage, yes. Yes, of course it can change.
By if conditionality, do you mean some kind of a mechanism or
kind of roadmap that you have to fulfill these conditions in order to move to the next chapter of negotiations? The Commission is putting conditions on waters, on health, on everything, rightly. We all agree, I think. Mm-hmm. It will be good they also put conditions also in the media freedom, in the media development, on media legislation, and also in its implementation. Because sometimes the approach of the EU has been very legalistic. You do a good law and that's fine. Mm-hmm. You can do very good laws in the Balkans, but this does not mean much. We write laws in European standards and we implement laws in Balkan standards, so it's complex.
Albania is pretty far from accession yet, but do you believe, knowing very well the problems with media especially, that when the time comes, Albania should join with some kind of a mechanism similar to that for Bulgaria and Romania, but addressing also the media situation to ensure sustainability?
Yes, the situation of media in Albania is not that different from the other countries. Might be actually worse in some aspects and better in some other aspects. For example, if Romania has too many cases of defamation trials against journalists, Albania has a very minimal cases, almost not. So it's very complex. But of course, Albania also needs to tackle media freedom situations, to tackle the pressure against media, which might come from politics, but not only, from business groups, from criminal groups. Mm-hmm. So, and it's time to put everything on the table and to talk and to, as I said, to have a roadmap of solutions.
Thank you very much. Thank you.